piece is called Confessions of a Shopaholic by Sophie Kinsella. I play Rebecca. Jane, I'm so sorry I'm late. This is shopping under cardiovascular activity. My heart never beats as fast as it does when I see a reduced by 50% sign. I count up the money in tens and twenties and wait, almost shivering, whilst the shop assistant ducks behind the counter and produces the green box. She slides it into a thick glossy bag with dark green cord handles and hands it to me. I almost want to close my eyes. The feeling is so wonderful. That moment, that instant when your fingers curl around the handles of a shiny, uncreased bag and all the gorgeous things inside it become yours. What's it like? It's like going hungry for days, then cramming your mouth full of warm buttered toast. It's like waking up and realising it's the weekend. Everything else is blocked out of your mind. It's pure selfish pleasure. Oh, cappuccino, please. Did you get it all right? He says, frowning slightly. What? Your aunt's present? Yes, I say and swallow. Yes, I got it. Is that it? He gestures to the bag and I feel my cheeks flame red. Yes, I say, eventually. I thought a scarf would be nice. Very generous of you. Denny and George, he raises his eyebrows. Your aunt must be a stylish lady. She is, I say, and clear my throat. She's terribly creative and original. I'm sure she is, says Luke, and pauses. What's her name? Oh, God, I should have run as soon as I saw him. While I had a chance, now I'm paralysed. I can't think of a single female name. Ermintrude, I hear myself saying. Aunt Ermintrude, says Luke thoughtfully. Well, give him my best wishes. He nods at me and walks off, and I stare after him, trying to work out if he guessed or not. You see, Jane, after all, I had asked him to have extra time to buy a present for my aunt. Thank you. I was ready for this.
Of a fairy tale.
another planet? Star. Vega. Look. A yellow star. Capella. And stars soon make shapes. Upside down M. Cassiopeia. But renamed upside down M. What's that shape?
A saucepan.
Hereafter known as Long John Saucepan. All these stars and shapes is moving, save one immovable star, which Long John Saucepan will lead you to. Imagine it all lifting its handle, like you're pouring stew. See the side the stew pours out? Two bright stars. Get the distance between them in your big brain. Yes. Now, how many of those distances to the very brightest star? North Star, Polaris, the one constant immovable star. Like Grandma, hereafter known as Grandma, head of all constellations. Hercules, the hero. Perseus, Agora, Cephas, Lyra, Ursa Minor, Little Bear. We use all this to find where we are in this dark, empty sea. We look to the horizon. Put our measuring fist from fat atop and count how many fists up to Polaris. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. A bright, bright star. And hey presto, you've turned into a human sextant.
What's a sextant?
A sextant is an instrument for measuring latitude.
I am a human instrument for measuring latitude.
How far north or south you are in this dark, empty earth. Human sextant, how many fists from horizon to Grandma's star?
A six.
If each fist is 10 degrees, six fists,
60 degrees.
And that's your latitude. And that's where you are right now. Latitude 60 degrees. Now you know exactly where you are, this whole great, wonderful world. Abracadabra!